today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Paulina Fialková, a Slovak biathlete, and I welcome you to Campus Sport magazine.
And this edition of Campus Sport is devoted to the Winter Universiade held in two countries, Slovakia and Spain. We'll look at the Nordic skiing at Strbske Pleso and the snow events organized in the Sierra Nevadas. And in part three, we'll move on to the ice competitions in Granada. Welcome to Campus Sport. The 27th Winter Universiade opened in Slovakia at Strbske Pleso, taking part 392 athletes from 31 nations in 9 days of competition. Cross-country skiing, the Nordic combined, and ski jumping. At the opening ceremony, the president of FISU, the International Federation of University Sports, had this to say.
Hold on to your dreams. Let all your dreams come true. During this Universiade, let us dream together, because when dreaming together, we can change the world, and this world certainly needs to be changed.
The Universiade is the second biggest sports event in the world. The games symbolize excellence in mind and body.
I really expect from the athletes that they will carry the thoughts of fair play, and they will compete clean, they will compete with the best ambitions and best results.
Osrblie in central Slovakia, the stage for the biathlon events. And great things expected from the local star Paulina Fialková. She took part in the Sochi Olympics, her best World Cup result, 10th at Kontiolahti. Now ready to go. Here at home.
You know,
it means a lot for me to start here at home. I love this course. And I like Osrblie. Paulina is a student of Matej Bell University in Banská Bystrica. She's working to make biathlon more popular in Slovakia. And now here she was, the 15-kilometer race, and fully focused. I wasn't nervous. I felt the support of the crowd, but I didn't shoot very well. And I said to myself, all right, you've got to really race fast, because I wanted to win a medal. So in the end, well, the bronze medal, that was fine for me. Paulina had missed the target four times during the race, but she finished only 40 seconds behind the winner. Alina Rykova of Kazakhstan took the gold, ahead of the Russian Katerina Avakumova. But Paulina knew she had a good chance in the sprint event. Well, I finally performed pretty well in the shooting, twice, without missing. That was important for me. It allowed me to be quick. And at the end of it all, I was euphoric. I skied fast, and as a result, I was able to win that gold medal. A great day for Slovakian biathlon. Paulina, the winner of the women's 7.5-kilometer sprint at home. She'd left Evgenia Pavlova almost 30 seconds adrift, despite the fact that the Russian was perfect with the rifle. Bronze went to Jitka Landova of the Czech Republic. But next up for Paulina, the pursuit, which didn't go quite to plan.
I
felt so good with bib number one because it gives you a great feeling. But I wasn't terribly successful with my first series of shots, two misses, and that was too much. And also, you know, I was a little bit tired and sick. And that was also the reason that I didn't ski as expected. But my other three performances in shooting were quite good, so I got the silver and I was satisfied with that. Evgenia Pavlova won the gold in the pursuit despite two penalties, and another Russian, Kristina Smirnova, took the bronze. Now Paulina had one more podium in her sights. I'm ready for the mass start. I feel a little bit better, a little bit less sick. I already have three medals, so I can't do much better than that, can I? Well, Paulina would finish ninth in the mass start, 2 minutes, 37 seconds behind the winner, Jitka Landova of the Czech Republic, who produced some excellent shooting and enormous speed on the skis. Another Czech, Iva Pukasikova, was second, with the Ukrainian Yana Bondar taking the bronze. The first competition for the men was the 20-kilometer race. And Ukraine's Dmytro Rusinov defied challenging conditions to fend off the Russian duo Vadim Filimonov and Yuri Shopin. 23-year-old Rusinov studying sports journalism at the State University in Sumy, simply too strong for the rest of them. He finished 22 seconds ahead of Filimonov and 1 minute 25 ahead of the talented Yuri Shopin. So where had Shopin lost the race?
On the shooting range, my shoot today was not so best. Yeah, I'm for the next races I need more practice with shooting. I can better.
Well, Shopin certainly showed his full potential in the 12.5-kilometer pursuit. He'd been behind in the early stages, but he was 100% accurate in his shooting and took advantage of the one error of Yaroslav Ivanov to prevail at the death. Maxim Burtasov made it a Russian 1-2-3. So to the mixed relay, 2x6 kilometers for the women, 2x7 for the men, and the race close right to the finish in heavy weather conditions. On the last leg, Shopin sprinting away to grab a new gold medal for Russia. Kazakhstan in second place, Ukraine third. The 15-kilometer mass start, and this time two Ukrainians running away with it. Vitaly Kilchitsky and Dmytro Rusinov. Yuri Shopin would get the bronze for Russia, and Russia, the top biathlon nation overall, with a total of 14 medals. Team Germany won the Nordic combined event ahead of Japan and Russia. And joy at the end of a big week for Germany's David Velder. Of course, it's the crowning highlight of the week. I'm so happy. I never expected that it would work out like this. Along with Velder, Tobias Simon and Johannes Vasel making up the German team, with the performance of Simon and Vasel in ski jumping helping to take them to the title. I think we made the base of our success on the hill, you know. The other two had really very good jumps. I wasn't so good for sure. But we performed very well in skiing, and another key fact, we have very good kit. So, in the end, everything came together. Velder's success had begun in the first individual competition. He was 13th in the ski jumping on the 100-meter hill. His teammate, Tobias Simon, was the top scorer. Defending champion, Adam Ciesla from Poland, was third best. Then to the 10-kilometer cross-country race and an incredible battle. Velder, who's strong in skiing, led the field ahead of Adam Ciesla. And over the final meters, they fought for the victory.
It was
a hard battle, really, against myself. I was in a kind of tunnel. I saw only dark, and then I tried to defend my lead and stay ahead of him at the finish. But unfortunately, it didn't quite work. 2 centimeters decided the outcome. And Adam Ciesla couldn't believe that he'd won this one more time. I'm really happy to be the World University champion for the second time. Looking forward to the 10-kilometer mass start combined, 21-year-old David Velder wanted gold, and he seemed quite relaxed. and Adam Ciesla warming up with his own way of managing stress before a race. Velde, showing his ambition once again, he was the leader after the cross-country phase ahead of Ciesla and Samim Mastev from Russia. The German had expected a lot from this event. Cross-country race was really good this morning, but in ski jumping, I wasn't so good. First jump, in fact, was poor because I was too nervous. But at least in the second jump, I was much better. I wasn't nervous anymore, more focused, and so I was able to perform better. Meanwhile, Ciesla was in great shape on both his jumps. In fact, the 22-year-old physical education student from the University of Warsaw was better than anyone. And he finally took the gold ahead of Velde and his teammate Matthias Vantolok. Well, I'm more than happy with my performance. To stay focused wasn't difficult to manage when I was on the hill. In fact, I jumped really well both times today, and I was able to handle the pressure. Before the Universiade, Adam Ciesla didn't know whether he would continue his sports career, but he left Strbske Pleso with 2 gold medals and a lot of confidence for the future. Irina Avakumova dominated the women's ski jumping. On the normal hill, the physical education student from Moscow defeated Yuka Kobayashi of Japan and the Russian Anastasia Gladysheva. I was able to win this competition due to the high quality of my training, and also my experience played a role. It's not the first time I've taken part in the university games. The Russian is 11th in the FIS World Cup standings. In fact, she took 2nd place at Zao in Japan, and her experience just too much for her opponents. I didn't make any special preparations here. I had to prepare for all my competitions, in fact. For the first time in the history of FISU, there was a women's team competition involving China, the Czech Republic, Russia, and Japan. Team Russia won, anchored by Irina Avakumova, with Japan 2nd and the Czechs 3rd. And for the FISU Secretary General, Eric Santron, satisfaction with the new competition. We were already the first to introduce women's ski jumping in the official competition. At the beginning, there were only 2 or 3 of them, but now we have a team event. Even though there aren't so many women's teams competing, we are the pioneers of this interesting official competition in ski jumping. In the men's individual competition, Vladimir Zografsky was the best, a score of 248.8 for him, ahead of the Russian duo Emir Hatzidinov and Evgeny Klimov. This was Zagraski after the victory. It's wonderful. Because, you know, over the last 2 years, I've had problems with my shape. My performance has suffered. Now, apparently, well, the performances are getting better. We'll see, but today certainly was a great day for me. In the team competition, Klimov, Maxim Ochkin, and Hatzidinov added another gold for Russia. You're watching Campus Sport, and in part 2 we go cross-country at Strbske Pleso. Then we move to southern Spain for the outstanding performances on the snow and alpine skiing and snowboarding. We'll also take a look at the ice competitions in Granada in just a moment.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
In Slovakia, the Russian delegation dominated the Winter University Games, especially in cross country. Russia has invested heavily in university sports, so the standard of their athletes is really high. Here's the president of their student sports union.
We really think that Universiade, especially, is a very good chance for young athletes as a reserve for national team, come here to as to demonstrate their potentials and to be in the future, present the country on the top level event like Olympic Games and World Championships.
17 cross-country medals, including 7 golds. The Russian students, supported by a comprehensive state system from the Ministry of Sport down, and the Russian Student Sports Union has set up a selection program which is seemingly working well. Andrei Feller, the winner of the 10-kilometer classic race, one of the beneficiaries.
Just a few days before Universiade, Federation decided to include him as a member of Russian delegation. And we celebrated here, just arrived January 22nd, and it was his birthday. So we, in our delegation, we celebrated, congratulated him. And for him, it was really chance to, how to say, to demonstrate. He is ready. He is one of the best, and he'd like to be a member of national team. So today we have seen the result.
Well, Andrei Feller was so motivated that he won the race, beating 2 other Russians, Atam Nikolaev and Valery Gonchar. What a day for him. The 5-kilometer classic race for women, and Anastasia Slonova gave it everything. Good enough for silver, but not enough to displace the defending champion. Oksana Osotova may have won before, but the Russian selection process is tough, and every time she competes, she has to prove she's one of the best. The race was very important for me, you know, because it's my favorite discipline, the 5-kilometer classic. But some people didn't have faith in me in the sprint, so today I wanted to prove that I was able to win. At the last Universiade, the Russian women's relay team finished only 9th. So here in Strbske Pleso, the team was highly motivated. Usatova, the first to go, and she established a lead that was never in danger. Silver for Kazakhstan, and the French would take the bronze. A student of sports and tourism in Kazan, 25-year-old Andrei Larkov would bring the Russian men's team home ahead of the field. It's my first Universiade, and I'll certainly remember the games because the competitions went really well for our team and for me. Larkov had already won gold in the first competition, the men's sprint. And he bagged a 3rd gold as part of an all-Russian podium in the men's 30-kilometer mass start. In cross-country, the rest of the world could only look on and learn.
I think that they are fast racers, and it gives us all someone to chase, and it makes me want to train harder year-round to be able to get higher places. So.
The Russian stranglehold in cross-country was broken only by Anastasia Slonova of Kazakhstan, the winner of 2 gold medals in the women's sprint and the 15 kilometers mass start. 26 of the 68 events in the Winter Universiade were contested in Slovakia. The rest were held in Spain. 1,180 athletes from 41 nations came together for the snow competitions in the Sierra Nevada and the ice competitions in Granada. The men's Super G raced on a difficult Universiade track. Of the 54 competitors, 12 didn't reach the finish line. Italy's Michelangelo Tentori was the winner by 1/100th of a second. Marco Oliveras from Andorra, the unlucky runner-up.
It was a very great day today. The slope was fantastic. The slope was amazing. The track is a perfect day. And I skied very well, especially at the second part of the track.
6 days later, Tentori got another gold, this time in the giant slalom. The Italian, quicker than his teammate Rocco Del Sante, by almost 1.5 seconds. The Frenchman, Jonas Fabre, third. So, with two golds in his pocket, Tentori, clearly a man of ambition.
It's important, but I hope that it's only the beginning and the best is yet to come.
The most successful female skier, Norway's Christina Osberg. And with victory in the Super-G and the giant slalom, Christina certainly fulfilling her potential.
I did some great races back home in Norway before this, and I came here with a lot of confidence. I hope that I can make more great results and ski up to my potential. Then I will be really satisfied if I can do that.
On to snowboarding, and after the Olympic title, now the Universiade title, and Patricia Kummer building up an impressive medal collection in parallel giant slalom. She'd taken part in the Universiade twice before, and she'd arrived in the Sierra Nevadas with high ambitions. I'm mega happy. I really can't believe it, because I'd already taken part twice. In the first, I was seventh, then fourth. So I said to myself, that's like -3 all the time, isn't it? That means that next time I can win it. And it happened. I'm so glad. Patricia is at the University of Bern taking a master's degree in neuropsychology. But right now, her sports career is taking precedence. She knows many of the competitors from the World Cup and the Olympics, so victory here was really sweet. It was super. I wasn't satisfied with the second qualification run, but then, from the first final run onwards, I really had the rhythm. I raced perfectly, except for one small mistake. I was able to perform just the way I wanted. In the final run, Patrizia defeated Selina Jürg of Germany, with the bronze going to the Italian Nadia Ochner. In her third Universiade, Kummer had achieved her goal of a gold medal. I always said this was a title I wanted to win. I always want to win when I set out my goals, so now to obtain this victory, super fun. The men's competition was close too, and there was a high-caliber final with Daniel Weiss of Germany defeating the South Korean Choi Bo-gun, who's eighth in the FIS international rankings. Austria's Alexander Peyer took the bronze. Still to come on campus sport, the ice competitions at the Winter University Games, with the top performances in figure skating, curling, short track, and ice hockey.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The ice sports at the Winter Universiade took place in Granada in Spain. The first figure skating gold went to Germany's Peter Liebers. The 26-year-old applied sciences student from Berlin captivated the spectators of the igloo. He'd finished eighth in Sochi. Now, after breaking his shoulder last September, he was back to perform his Olympic program. Liebers took the title ahead of Japan's Takahiko Kozuka and Russia's Artur Kaczynski. The pair's gold medal going to Yu Xiaoyu and Jin Yang. The Russians Kristina Astakhova and Alexei Roganov took silver, with Vanessa James and Morgan Sipra claiming the bronze for France. In ice dancing, Charlina Ginaur and Marco Fabri of Italy were the best. spectators loved it. They took the gold. In second place, the Spanish dancers, Sara Hurtado and Adrian Diaz. And third, Frederica Testa and Luca Scholli from Slovakia. In 2012, the Russian skater Elena Leonova was the silver medalist at the World Championships in Nice. Here in Granada, she struck gold. May Berenice Mitre of France was second, and another Russian, Maria Artemieva, took the bronze. On to the curling, and the Canadian women meeting the reigning champions from Russia. The gold medal game, a tight encounter, but finally the Russians coming through to retain their title. They are a very experienced team. Switzerland taking the bronze after defeating Sweden 8-7. In the men's final, Norway were the surprise champions. In the final, they beat the Russians 7-6. The bronze went to Great Britain after winning against Sweden 7-4. In the spectacular sport of short track speed skating, the South Koreans have carved out quite a reputation, and they collected a total of 12 medals in Granada. Park Se-yong is among the best in the world, so no surprise when he won the 1500 meters and the 1000. And the Korean women made it a clean sweep in their 1000 meter race. Kim Alang capturing gold to add to the gold she won in the 1500 meter race. She finished in front of Lee Yong-byul and Son Hak-yong. In the women's 3000 meter relay, China took the gold, beating Korea and Canada. As for the men, it was a 5,000 meter relay, and China again ahead of Russia and France in third place. Ice hockey, and this the women's gold medal game. And the Russians against the Canadians. Second period, Anna Shokin scoring first for Russia. Into the third, and once again, Anna Shokin was the scorer. 2-0. Valeria Pavlova made it 3, and gold for the Russians. No score for the Canadians, so they would take the silver. Bronze to Japan, who beat China 4-1. And so to the final event of the 27th Winter Universiade, the men's ice hockey final, and a clash between two nations who'll welcome the Winter Games in 2017 and 2019 respectively, Kazakhstan and Russia. The Russians opening in the score in the first period, and a few minutes later, a shot from Igor Krivchenko would make it 2. Russia in the hunt for their 6th Universiade triumph since 1993. Time for Alexander Torchenyu to make his name. This was the second period, and Russia increasing their lead to 3. It was Kazakhstan's second final in a row after losing in Trentino to Canada 2 years ago. Renat Safin got a goal for them, but again, they'd leave the games as silver medalists. 3-1, the final score. Celebrations for the Russian team in the final event of the Universiade.
No, it was not easy because Kazakhstan had a lot of moments. They might score a lot of goals, you know, but our keeper did a very great job. A lot of important saves.
So yet another goal for Russia, silver to Kazakhstan, Canada taking the bronze, beating the Czech Republic 6-2. And the final medals table, a total of 56 for Russia, including 20 golds, Korea winning 16 medals, and Kazakhstan 11. At the closing ceremony, Claude-Louis Gallien, the FISU president, passing the flag to the delegates of the city of Almaty in Kazakhstan, which will host the 28th Winter Universiade in 2017. The 2015 Winter Universiade has seen events take place in 2 countries, Slovakia and Spain. In total, 2,400 athletes from 540 universities had come together to experience a few days in their life that they will never forget.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,